In this video, we'll be sharing our tips on how to approach JVs and get them to actually promote for you, even if you're just starting out.
Yeah, you don't have a list at all yet, but with this little trick, you can get started and get the big guys to take attention or put attention to what you're what you're offering there.
Yeah, so keep watching.
I think one thing that we could cover is the little free coaching session that we just gave there.
Consultation.
Mm-hmm.
One hour
consultation we did just there.
And why we should charge for a comp. No, just kidding.
And why we shouldn't do that all the time, because otherwise we wouldn't get any work done. No, but the thing is,
not that it's a big issue.
The interesting part is what we noticed there. It seemed like what was necessary, kind of like to help the other person to get started, was a lot of how to information.
He knows the what.
He knows the what, yeah. But so he's missing the how to. I mean, and they're like a step-by-step kind of like action plan. That's what's kind of what's missing, no?
So in case you're lost, we're just talking about a student of ours. Let's say one of our attendees for our someone from the audience.
Yep.
Just needed help.
A little brainstorm on Skype.
Yeah, brainstorm his idea. Seems like he knows what sort of things and methods to use and what to do.
But he knows what the outcome is that he wants, for sure.
That's right.
And he's just like a little bit unsure about it.
He needed a clear path, sort of connected dots sort of method, because it's all over the place at the moment.
Yeah, he seemed to have he basically did something that's good. He looks at what's working out there right now. What does he see other people do? And then how can he now emulate or copy learn from these different successes that he sees out there and implement in his own business? And I think one of the points that I tried to make clear, and I hope he understood it, I think he understood it at the end, was that even though it's good to see or to have an idea what the end goal is going to be like, that you're looking for. Like the end goal is maybe, build a huge business like XYZ has, like this person has or that person has, right?
Success leaves clues, apparently, it's easier to follow in someone's footpath.
Well, yeah, it's kind of like you see...
starting from scratch.
You see what they have and you want something like that, right? Okay, so now the thing is just that a lot of those cases where we look at them and say, well, that would be great to do, or this would be great if I would have that kind of site to offer. It didn't happen overnight for those people, and they probably built it up over
years.
Years probably more, not just days and weeks and months, but years. Over years they built it up. And it's just, it's even though it's good to have an idea how your end goal looks like, it's good to just be able to pick one little aspect of that main huge business empire and just focus on that one little aspect and build that out first.
So dissect like a bigger part or bigger method of it, then implement that so you can see results faster.
Also, though, even though it's great to have everything perfect from the beginning, you're most likely not going to get perfect from the beginning. Don't worry too much about that, but
It needs to be functional, at least usable.
Right. What you build initially might not be the thing that the way it's going to look like 5 years from now, right? It's just going to be a step on the way to the end goal that you try to achieve.
Yeah, like we mentioned, like you take two steps forward and one step back, but in the end, you're always moving forward in the end.
You adjust your approach based on what you hear from customers, based on what you see works and what doesn't work, and you adjust the approach. But the most important part is just be able to pick one little aspect of it and work on that aspect, do it done. So one thing that we recommended to him, he was very concerned about how does he, for example, find JV partners that promote it afterwards, how to get the traffic to it afterwards.
Yeah, because he doesn't have his own network of JV partners and people who regularly work with.
So, and my point where was basically saying see how you can provide some kind of a value to a single site owner with an existing list out there that you want to leverage by by maybe customizing what you're offering specifically for their audience.
Right.
See how you can add extra value to their members or their customers or their affiliates or whatever it is. If you, for example, have a, you know, a strategy that works great in generating traffic with, let's say, Google Plus, right? You know, you're good with Google Plus. Jason comes to mind. He's no good with Google Plus.
Yeah.
So if he can
quite a lot of traffic from that.
If he can teach others how to do what he does.
Yeah.
And then he, you know, creates a training or like a little report, like a PDF or whatever it is, a little video. That teaches that method and then puts it behind a squeeze page, then I do not mind
promoting that
squeeze page to my own list to help my affiliates become more effective.
Because in the end, it's beneficial for your members.
Right. It helps. It's a win-win-win. It helps me as a site owner because I become better. I get better affiliates that are becoming more effective. Right. It helps the affiliates.
You're getting the customers to consume your site product service.
Or promote it in this case, yeah. Right. And you know, it helps the affiliates themselves because they learn a new strategy that they might not have been aware of before to generate traffic, and it helps the person that teaches that because they can build their mailing list that way and then maybe even upsell them on more advanced training or like another training method. It's like, hey, opt in here for getting, you know, free access to this Google Plus training. And and then the upsell could be something like, you know, I have another five methods that I teach, that I can teach you on how to generate traffic, really great. If you'd like to see that, you know, for an extra seven, or for just $7, you can access that or whatever it is, right? Yeah. Have a little bit of an upsell there.
Additional training,
yeah.
What it is, yeah.
And then, hey, if whatever they get helps me as a site owner, helps my members or my affiliates, and helps you, great. That's something I wouldn't mind.
So win-win for everyone. Yeah? Win-win-win. That is, and you always have to think about what's in it for me when you are approaching these site owners.
Well, actually, what's in it for them?
Yeah, what's in it for them? Sorry, but from their perspective, yeah.
Right.
When they read your proposal, it should be what's in it for me.
And especially, you know, one thing to consider is, you know, somebody who is already established out there that you're approaching is that maybe the whatever X percent commission that you're offering them on the upsells is not really the main benefit for them. They want to see that. There's some value provided already even on the free part for those people that they refer. You know, if they can provide something cool to their own members and their own list, they wouldn't mind doing so. It's not necessarily about the $3.50 commissions that they earn on the upsell or something, you know.
No.
That's the point. You know, especially a lot of big, you know, marketers out there, they will, if you come with anything that doesn't earn them like a couple of $100, they wouldn't even promote it for the reason of money.
Yeah, they'll just ignore your message, email.
You know, if it's like you have a $497 course and they can earn $250 on each sale, yeah, they might do that then for that reason. But otherwise, it's not really about the money. It's more about the
how it's going to benefit their members and affiliates and so on.
Yeah, you know, and if it helps their members in a way that they become more efficient, if they can consume their product better, if they can become a better affiliate or more effective affiliate, then it benefits them in the end as well. So that's what it's all about, you know, providing value.
Yeah, that's it.
Okay, well, I think that's it for today.
That's
it. Let's go in and get our food. See ya.
Yeah, so keep watching.
Okay, see ya.
Probably not see ya. It's like the end of the
cut
video.
That out.
Yeah.
You know, in the end, it's a bit of a GV part method.
Importance of what are we... No, actually, we'll do it again. My mind just went blank.
The...